with arms wide open, he'll pardon you. It is no secret what God can do.
Alright. So, do we have any prayer requests from the crowd here this morning? Or
say family verses for all the chuckers out here.
Sure.
Always. That's our goal.
That's one of our regular prayers out here every morning. So.
I got a praise for my buddy Huey. It's still doing good.
Okay.
With his cancer that he's had.
Nice.
Yeah, we got Jeremy on there, so.
Okay. All right, so if you'll join me for prayer this morning.
Sure.
Lord, we thank you for this day that you've given us. Thank you for the beautiful weather we've got outside, Lord. We pray for our drivers that are out there on the roads. Pray for their safety, navigating traffic and navigating weather conditions. And then we pray for them as they're away from their families, Lord. Pray for their loneliness and the loneliness of their families while they're away, Lord. You know what they're going through, and Lord, we pray for those that we've got on our list battling for cancer. We've got Jeremy, Gwen, Caleb, and Roy, and then we pray for those who have other health concerns, Lord. We've got two Lindas, and then we've got Diane, and then Lord, we praise for Heath this morning, Lord, and we're glad you're, you know, seeing your working healing hand in his life, Lord, and we pray for our services here this morning, that someone will hear something that they need to hear, and their heart will be open to receive it, Lord. And pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, the only one.
be very sure. Be very sure. Your anchor holds the solid rock. In times like these, I have an idol. In times like these, I have an anchor. I'm very sure. I'm very sure. My anchor holds to the solid rock. This rock is Jesus. He's the one. This rock is Jesus.
Message is coming out of James chapter 1. We're going to be looking at verses 2 and 3. James chapter 1, verses 2 and 3. Starts out, my brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together and worship your holy name today, Lord. We ask that you just do a mighty work in this service, Lord, to guide my tongue, that the message that comes forth would truly be your message, Lord, that would reach out to souls and bring them closer to you, Lord. Lord, and if they don't know you as Lord and Savior, let this be the day they come to that saving knowledge of you. Just guide and direct in all things, and let your will be done. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Starts out, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. You notice it doesn't say if you fall into temptations. It says when you fall into temptations.
Amen.
We all have them. Every one of us. We've all had these trials in our lives. Being saved isn't the easy way to heaven. It's the only way, but it's not the easy one. Nobody promises it's going to be an easy trip.
So true.
There are still going to be problems, trials, and temptations along the way. John chapter 16 verse 33 tells us, these things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace, in the world ye shall have tribulation. But be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. You know, we have a hope, because God has overcome those problems for us.
Yes.
Someday we'll have the good fortune. Thanks to God, thanks to Jesus and what he did to be in heaven with him. And we have the peace today of that knowledge. Acts 14:22 tells us, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the flesh, and that we must through much tribulation enter into the kingdom of God. Again, we got those problems we have to deal with. And I just can't, I couldn't go through this without bringing up this example, Paul. What Paul went through in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 27. Paul says, "Are they ministers of Christ? I speak as a fool. I am more. In labors more abundant, in stripes above measure, in prison more frequent, in deaths oft. Of the Jews 5 times received I 40 stripes save one. Thrice was I beaten with rods. Once I was I stoned. Thrice I suffered shipwreck. A night and a day I have been in the deep. In journeys often, in perils of water, in perils of robbers, in perils of my own countrymen, in perils by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in the wilderness, in perils in the sea, in perils among false brethren, in weariness and painfulness, in watching often, in hunger and thirst, in fasting often, in cold and nakedness." You know, I've had some trials in my 67 years of life, but it don't compare to this.
So true.
Another example is the book of Job. We can go back and look at Job. The whole book is about a guy who lost his family, lost his wealth, lost everything for Christ. There's going to be trials and temptations before us. We are God's scattered people, not his sheltered people. But we're to count it all joy. It's all about attitude. You know, I've brought this up many times when I've been up here. I spent too many years in the Army. But I had a sergeant one time who used to always tell us, "There is no such thing as a problem. There are only challenges and opportunities." And you know, he was right. It's all about your attitude. A problem is a negative. A challenge and an opportunity is a positive. It's a potential to move forward. God wants us to seize that moment for him, to accept the challenge, to strengthen our faith in him, and to reach out to others. James verse 3 tells us, "Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience." There's a purpose for the trials that we face. There's a trial for every goal in life. If you want to be a lawyer or a doctor or an accountant, you got to go to school for it. If you're like me, school was a trial.
Amen.
If you're going to be a bodybuilder, you got to break a sweat in the gym for it. Nobody gets to be a general without being a lieutenant first. Nobody gets to be a sergeant without being a private. We all have those trials that come with the goals in our lives. A Christian has to face the trials and the tribulations to grow in Christ before going to heaven. We've got to get closer to him. But know that as a Christian, you are victorious. My favorite verse in the whole Bible, 1 Corinthians 10:13. "There hath no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will, with temptation, also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it." I thank God for that verse. There have been times when I've looked at it and refer back to that. We're not alone in our trials. There's many great men of God who have gone before us and faced the same problems. Now, you can go back to biblical characters. Abraham took Hagar as his second wife, and it almost destroyed his life. Moses killed an Egyptian and had to flee for 40 years. Peter denied Christ 3 times and went out and wept. Our friends and our neighbors, they got trials and tribulations too. They may not tell you over the back fence, but they're going through the same things that we are. Romans chapter 5, verses 1 through 5 tells us, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into his grace wherein we stand, and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Patience means growth. It means maturity. Our trials will help us to grow in our Christian faith, in our Christian maturity. They'll make us grow stronger. They'll bring us closer to the Lord. They'll make us more dependent on Him. Romans chapter 8, verse 28 says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to His purpose. Our trials, our temptations, our problems are for our own good. You know, when I was about that high, and Dad said, no, this is for your own good, I didn't believe him. Sometimes when he tells me this is for my own good, I still have that problem. But it's still right. It's for my own good. James's message to us is to grow up. We need trials to grow up. God wants us to grow up. God wants us to have joy in our trials, knowing that in the end, we're going to be closer to Him. But there are those out there. We deal with them every day, people out there in the world, who don't know their Lord as their Savior. They don't have the comfort and support of the Lord in their trials. They're alone in those trials. But you know what? Even for them, there's hope. Because John 3:16 tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. God is still holding out that gift of salvation to them. Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All of us have sinned. Amen. You ever told a lie? You ever taken something that wasn't yours? Have you ever put something else ahead of God? How many times do we see people going to the kids' football game instead of serving the Lord? going to work for the almighty dollar instead of serving the Lord. It happens every day. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death." The wages of sin is death, or eternal separation from God. God's in heaven. That means hell. We are going to go to hell for our sins, and it only takes one sin to make us a sinner. You only have to murder one person to be a murderer. There's no difference. The verse goes on, but, and I just love that word in that verse. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Yes.
God has made us a way to escape. Just like he said in Corinthians 10:13, there's a way to escape. That way is Jesus. Romans 5 verse 8 says, "But God commandeth his love toward us, and that while we were still yet sinners, Christ died for us." God loves us. He loves us so much that God gave his only son for us. Christ died for us when we were not worthy. Christ died for us sinners. Romans 10 verses 9 to 11 says, "That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture saith, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed." And how can we accept that free gift of God that he's holding out? By believing in Jesus. By believing that he died on the cross for our sins. By believing that he rose from the dead. By believing that he ascended into heaven. That he sits on the right hand of God advocating for us today. By believing that he has the power and the glory, and that he is in charge of everything forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
By believing that he saves. You see, we can't save ourselves. Salvation only comes by the grace of God through faith in Jesus. That's the only way. And when we believe, and when we have faith, and when we are saved, we want to tell others about it. "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." That's everybody. That shall be saved. It's not might be saved. It shall be saved. You will be saved. And when we are saved, we've got Jesus on our side for the trials and tribulations.
Yes.
He makes a way to escape. So we can truly have joy in our troubles. If you have not received the Lord as your Savior, contact us here at the chapel. Talk to Alan, talk to me. Email. Stop in, call. We'd love to work with you on this. There is a potential for joy in our troubles. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this opportunity, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you just do a mighty work in everybody's lives here today, Lord, and those that listen in, Lord. We just ask guidance and direction for each and every one of us, that we might have a closer walk with thee. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. Alan? Uh-huh.
Okay, we're going to finish up with Sweet By and By.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it far. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. It's a sweet by and by we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore. Sorrow no more. Now the sigh for the blessing of rest in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. Father above, we shall offer our tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that follow our days. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall be on that beautiful shore.
I appreciate everybody coming out and visiting us this morning. Those of you online, thank you. I apologize to the YouTubers. You're going to have to watch it later because they wouldn't let me go on live this morning. You're welcome to stick around and chat for a little bit, and we'll see the rest of you next week. Thank you.
Thank you.